안녕하세요. So the grammar we're going to do now is 보다. 네, comparison mark예요. 이게 뭐예요? 우리 바로 봅시다. 여기 when two items are compared, 보다 is attached to the noun which is being compared to. It is sometimes used with 더, which means more. 네. 자, 우리 example sentence 예문을 봐요. 예문. 네. 한국어가 재미있어요. 자, what is this? What does this mean? Korean is interesting. So, Korean language, 한국어가 한국어. 재밌어요. Interesting. 자, this is a perfectly proper sentence. That full proper sentence이에요. But let's say we want to give more information to this sentence. 예를 들면, 영어보다 한국어가 재밌어요. 자, 이게 뭐예요? Compared. That compared to English, we're comparing to English, 한국어가 재밌어요. So, 여기, compared는 보다예요. So, 보다. So, compared to English. 괜찮죠? As you can see, the sequence is different for Korean language and English language. 왜냐하면 in Korean, we say 영어보다. 하지만 in English, is compared to. 그쵸? So, the sequence is different. 이거 주의하세요. Just take note of this. 자, 그럼 영어보다 한국어가 재밌어요. Compared to English, Korean is interesting. Now, we're going to look at the same sentence with some changes. 이거 보세요. 자, 한국어가 영어보다 재밌어요. 이거 is exactly the same sentence, but something is being switched. 여기, as you can see, the 한국어가 and 영어보다, they have changed position. This is the same meaning. There's no difference. So what I'm trying to say here is it doesn't matter how you say it. They mean the same thing. 네, 한국어가 영어보다 재미있어요. It's fine too. 괜찮죠? So 여기 영어보다 한국어가 재미있어요. 한국어가 영어보다 재미있어요. Both the same. However, I would usually recommend students to use the first one. This one. 영어보다 한국어가 재미있어요. 네, 왜냐하면 without this, 한국어가 재미있어요. 네, and the extra information is put in front and then after that you just say the main sentence. It's easier for your brain to process, I think, especially if you're learning this for the first time. 네, so 영어보다 한국어가 재미있어요. I think it's easier for you to process, but maybe some of you is very fast, and this is fine for you as well. 한국어가 영어보다 재밌어요. Okay? 자, 좋아요. 그럼 이제 우리 더, let's look at how we use 더. So, 한국어가 영어보다 더 재밌어요. So, what you need to take note is usually 더 is put right in front of the adjectives, that the descriptive verb or the action verb. So, 더 재밌어요. So, 한국어가 영어보다 더 재밌어요. If you were to put this in the first sentence, you would say something like, you would say, 영어보다 한국어가 더 재밌어요. So, 더 is always in front of the, directly in front of the verb or adjective. 자, 우리 다른 예문, another example 봅시다. 저는 액션 영화를 좋아해요. 자, so, 액션 영화. 영화 movie예요. I like action movies. 자, usually in English, we would say like I like action movies more than horror movies. 자, how would you say this? 한국어 생각해보세요. 네, pause the video, 비디오를 멈추세요 and think about it. 어떻게 해요, 이거? 자, 저는 공포 영화보다 액션 영화를 좋아해요. 네, so 여기 공포 영화보다 액션 영화를 좋아해요. 네, 자, the point here is usually students would think this as like a fan, 네, because this is usually how we say it in English. But I think this would confuse you more because the sequence is like totally is different in English. We don't say more than horror movies I like. So I would usually recommend for students who like to translate this in your head, in your brain, to think of it as compared to instead of than. 네? So think of it more like a compared to. So compared to horror movies, 공포 영화보다 action 영화를 좋아해요. Of course, we can switch this. Of course, let's do this first. So, 저는 action 영화를 좋아해요. 공포 영화보다. 공포 영화보다 action 영화를 좋아해요. Okay? So, it's really easier. The point here is, it's really easier to think of this as compared to. 네. 자, 다음에 이거. 저는 액션 영화를 공포 영화보다 좋아해요. Exactly the same sentences. It's just that the grouping is changed. Okay? 자, 그럼 우리 practice, 연습합시다. Let's practice. So, pause the video. 비디오를 멈추세요. 그리고 쓰세요. Write this down. 네, 번역해보세요. Translate this. Pause the video. Always try. 항상 해봐야 돼요. 자, 그리고 이제 premature. 힌트 나와요. 이거 힌트예요. So if you, 네, 힌트예요. 이거 most of the sentences is there. Just we have to fill in the blanks. 해보세요. 어떻게 해요? 자, you can write it this way. Or this way is fine. Again, I would recommend this one, but this is fine just as well. 자, 그럼 비디오를 멈추세요. 생각해보세요. 네, always try. 그리고 이제 답안 알려드릴게요. Let you know the answer. 답안이 나와요. So 여기 저는 수박보다 포도를 더 좋아해요. 네, 1번. 2번, 토끼보다 호랑이가 더 멋있어요. So, 더는 optional예요. But if you're going to use 더, must be in front of the adjectives, the adjective or the action verb. 네, 더 좋아해요, 더 멋있어요. 3번, 저는 한국 영화보다 한국 드라마를 더 좋아해요. 네, 자, 다음에 4번, 저보다 동생이 안 똑똑해요. So 이거 compare to me, comparing to me, 동생이 not clever, 안 똑똑해요. So in this case, you don't use 더. It's just comparing to me, she's not clever. 자, or you can say the other way around. 이것도 괜찮아요. Sequence change, 이거 same meaning이에요. As long as the markers are put correctly, the sentences mean the same thing. Okay? 자, 그럼 이거 보다예요. 그럼 여기까지입니다. 감사합니다.